Hello, I'm going to present the work, a model for the development of programming courses to promote the participation of young women in STEM, by Marta Contreras Ortiz, Vilma Ojeda Caicedo, Lina Marrugo Salas, and me, Sonia Contreras Ortiz. We all know that there is a gender gap in STEM fields, especially in physics, engineering, and computer science. Some of the factors that explain that gap is a masculine culture. For example, stereotypes, insufficient early experience, girls do not use technological toys and video games in the same proportion as boys, and gender gap in self-efficacy. Frequently, girls feel that they are not good for math and science. The World Economic Forum did a study in 2020 where they analyzed the emerging jobs. They found 8 clusters of emerging jobs and found that there are gender gaps in most of these clusters, especially in those related with technological skills, such as data and artificial intelligence, engineering, and cloud computing. In Colombia, we have a deficit of systems engineers, and this especially after the onset of the pandemic. In order to contribute to the reduction of the gender gap in STEM fields, we developed an online summer course in programming as one of the activities of the WSTEM project. This was on July 2020. The course lasted a week. It was offered free of charge to high school students of the city of Cartagena in Colombia. More than 60 students registered from 10th and 11th grade, and 25 students attended and completed the activities. They were 16 girls and 9 boys. The goals of the course were to learn the principles of computer programming, to develop computational logic skills, and to use variables and control structures to solve basic engineering problems. And some of the topics were fundamental of programming, input and output data, use of variables, selection control structures, and iterative control structures. So this is the model. The model has 3 components: human component, technological component, and pedagogical component. In the human component, we have instructors. Instructors are female professors of systems engineers. We chose female professor because we want to have them as female role model for the girls. And the student were mixed gender group with emphasis on girls. The technological component. We use Google Classroom to have the class materials. We use Google Meet for video conferencing. And we use Colab for programming environment. We use also Python as programming language. And in the pedagogical component, we have case-based learning and algorithm, digital learning resources, a performance assessment, both qualitative and quantitative, and surveys that were applied to students and instructors. Okay, the results. 65% of the students reported that the summer course was their first experience in virtual programming training. 100% of the students rated the activities, communication tools, content, and learning as excellent and very good. 100% of instructors rated the experience in the program as excellent. And some of the students' perceptions were beautiful experience, excellent methodology. Some of the instructor perceptions were good participation of students. They kept the motivation up to the end. Contents according to the age. For conclusions, we have: the article proposes a model for the development of programming courses for high school students, especially girls, but it can be applied to boys. The model has 3 components: human, technological, and pedagogical. And it includes assessment instruments that are applied both to students and instructors. The results of the first course that we developed are very positive, and we expect to continue applying and adjusting this model in the future. These are the references of the work. Thank you very much.